What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Critical Overlord here. In this video, I'm just going to be sharing my thoughts on a theory that's been making its way around the internet. It's actually been a theory that's been around for a few years now. This theory originates from the year 2013. I got this from Screen Rant, and we got this covered. They took a theory from a blog. This original theory comes from a blog back from 2013, talking about the fact that Michael Myers might not be our actual villain in the Halloween franchise, but while he's a villain, he's also a villain that started off as a victim. So the theory basically is elaborating on the fact that Michael Myers was manufactured and created by his own doctor, Dr. Sam Loomis, while they were together during those 15 years while he was still at Smith's Grove before he broke out. It also goes into details about Michael having assistance from getting out of Smith's Grove by Loomis himself, how Loomis basically was. Before I get ahead of myself, I'll just preface what I find interesting about this. This whole entire theory, it's interesting to consider this now, knowing what we got in the 2018 film, because we got something that almost mirrors this theory exactly. A doctor that is very fascinated in the mechanisms of a patient who is virtually insane. There's no help for this person. Everyone has deemed Michael as a lost cause. He's the embodiment of evil. Dr. Sartain basically is fulfilling this theory in a way, because of the fact that in Halloween 2018, we know that Dr. Sartain, he's the reason that, or it's implied that he's the reason that Michael got out. He's also the one that set Michael on track to have a final clash with Laurie Strode, because he was just fascinated of, while Michael was his patient, as to why Michael went after her, what made him tick, what made him kill Judith all these years ago. We don't specifically know what went on during that time Sartain spent with Michael between 78 to 2018. But it's just very, very coincidence. It's such a coincidence to me. I find it very odd and ironic that what happened with Sartain almost mirrors exactly what this theory is talking about when it comes to Dr. Loomis and what happened in the 1978 film. So the theory, again, is reiterating that we don't know what happened in between the 60s when Michael killed Judith to 1978. All we know is brief details and what Dr. Loomis has to say, because Michael hasn't spoken for 15 years at this point. Michael hasn't spoken apparently since the night that he killed Judith. But an important thing to remember about the night that he killed Judith and that brief moment where we do see his face at the end of the 1978 film, there's almost like this confused, innocent child look on him. Like, he doesn't know he has no idea or comprehension of what he's doing, and he feels some type of remorse for it, but he just, for some reason, he can't stop. Something is making him do these things, and the look on his face after he kills Judith and his parents find him, to the look he has when Laurie removes his mask for a brief second in the 1978 film, both of those expressions are very similar in the fact that Michael looks stunned and shocked and horrified at these actions he's committing, and he's almost childlike. Like, he looks like he doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know how to ask for help. He doesn't actually look satisfied with the work he's done, but for some reason he can't seem to stop. And a lot of people have talked about this in the past, but this particular theory, again, from a blog from 2013, states that what if Dr. Sam Loomis basically manifested and contributed to everything that we got in the 1978 film, not in a way that he, of course, he purposely let Michael out, but he didn't tell Michael to go after any specific person. He purposely came up with the idea and was very fascinated with Michael and deemed him to be the embodiment of all evil. He said he met this six-year-old child with this blank, pale, emotionless face and the blackest eyes, the devil's eyes. Now, that expression that he's describing is one of the best quotes out of any horror film in cinema history. That's a quote that a lot of people go back to and reference from the original movie and just film in general. Dr. Sam Loomis's description for his patient, Michael Myers. that description though does not match the look we see on a young 6 year old at the end of the beginning of the first movie after he kills Judith. That look is not blank, pale, and emotionless. That look is, what have I done? Help me. What did I just do? I don't know what just happened. I'm disgusted with what I just saw. I know I did it, but I don't know why. I have no comprehension of why I did that. Someone please help me. It looks like a child who's confused and they need help. That's what Michael looks like at the end or at the beginning of the original movie and at the end when Lori removes his mask for a brief second. So Loomis's description almost sounds as if what this theory is saying, because this is the theory on this blog, it's almost as if Loomis just came to believe that. That's what he wanted to believe. And so Loomis himself also does have a few toxic traits to him that are developed, of course, in the later sequels. And Halloween 5 is like one of my least favorite portrayals of Dr. Loomis. He is almost antagonizing Jamie for the fact that she doesn't want to speak up, as if he's almost forgetting that Jamie is innocent in all this. He's like a crazed man at this point. He's not being fair to Jamie. He's acting very toxic towards Jamie. But some of those traits could have been, let's just say, he acted that way towards Michael when he was trying to reason with Michael and he was trying to get to Michael, understand him. But dozens of failures, maybe some type of verbal abuse was let out from Loomis, and he just came to believe that, okay, well, since you don't want to talk, maybe you are just an evil boy. You're just an evil child, and you're never going to amount to anything. You're just pure evil. You killed your sister for no reason because you're just, that's just how sick you are. Maybe Michael was talked down to from Loomis while he was in Smith's Grove, and Loomis was manipulative towards him, and he just gave up on Michael the same way that everyone else had, his parents, the town of Haddonfield, everyone who deemed Michael to be a lost cause. And then you have his doctor, who already from the movies, it does, Loomis on from the later sequels and the original, he does come across a bit as if he hates humanity in a way. I kind of got that vibe. It's almost as if he wanted to save Michael, not necessarily because he wanted to save Haddonfield, but because he wanted to save Michael for himself and put him back in Smith's Grove and do some type of... He realizes that what he did is wrong in the end, because again, the theory is expressing that Loomis basically set Michael loose. His arrival with Marion Chambers, Michael supposedly found a way out the night, that same night when they were going to pick him up so he can be transferred, but he found a way out and he let all these other patients out. The theory just is just speculating that maybe Dr. Loomis was the one who assisted him in this. Maybe Dr. Loomis did something prior to picking up Marion Chambers, or he did something a few nights ago that led to Michael escaping the next night when he was meant to be picked up and transferred to another facility for his court hearing or something. I believe that's what they were going to pick him up for. I like the theory. I know I'm not really getting into much details because I'm going to leave a link to it down in the comment section for everyone to read this. It's just when you sit down and you think about it, how much of a coincidence this is that this very theory is actually how Dr. Sartain was portrayed in the 2018 movie. Just a psychiatrist who has a separate agenda. He wants to know what makes Michael tick, but he's willing to sacrifice a few lives in the process. And that's what this blog user is theorizing when it comes to Dr. Loomis and his relationship with Michael, and the fact that we don't know much of what went on in between the 60s back to 1978, those 15 years, outside of what Dr. Loomis is telling us, because he's the one that can speak. Michael, for one reason or another, just stops speaking. He ceases to speak. He hasn't spoken a word since he killed his sister. So it's very possible that, yes, Michael was abused by Loomis mentally, verbally, and Loomis gave up on him the same way everyone else had, and he just came to accept that Michael was evil. He wanted to see what made Michael tick, just so for his own sick game, to see if his own psychotic creation was actually as evil as he envisioned it to be. But let me know what you guys think about all this down in the comment section below. Again, my rough synopsis of this theory probably isn't what you'll actually be reading in this blog. That's just a few tidbits of it. But let me know what you guys think about that down in the comment section below. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Turn on post notifications so that you never miss a video. In the description, I have links on my social media accounts, my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can message me there to let me know if there's any movies, news, or reviews you'd like me to cover in the future. With all that in mind, guys, I will see you in the next video.